I'm good.
Now you're on.
Welcome to our second semifinal of the 2021 Danny Swag Hoop Classic on the ladies' side. And this one is something we're anticipating, hopefully to be a nice, tight, close game, just like our first one was, which was terrific, Meg and Campbell. But have any rooting interest in this game at all, or?
I mean, yeah, fans, you missed the first one there. Maybe that just hopping on, but it was an excellent game, our first semifinal game at 6 p.m. between St. Malachy's Saints and the Harrison Triple Trojans, and I think it might have been a little bit of an upset, actually. A little bit.
I thought for sure the Trojans were – I made them the favorites, that's for sure.
Yeah, so the Saints came away with a three-point victory over the Trojans, and they'll take the gold medal game tomorrow against the winner of this game tonight. So – if you're just tuning in, welcome to the broadcast, and we're looking forward to a really good second final game here.
Yeah, this is going to be fun. So, and they're doing a little warm-up for tomorrow's games, where we're going to have an announcer at the bench, and we're going to have some fans, and we're going to have, you know, so a little bit of a warm-up for tomorrow, and the kids got a little jolt of energy, I think, from the introductions in the first game, and I think it feels a little bit more like a big tournament now.
Yeah.
We're kind of ramping
I'm
up
a
for
fan
tomorrow.
Of it, yeah.
Yeah, I love this stuff. You know the kids do too. Mm-hmm. And that is a very intimidating Moncton Purple Knights starting lineup. This has been a fun team to watch all tournament. And starting with Beach up front, Lindsay Black, Ella DeVarin, Samia Amadou, Sammy, and Brooke Watson.
Mm-hmm. Lindsay Black will take the tip here against Ella McNally.
A terrific combo of five for Moncton, and Deverin wastes no time in the feed.
First 3 seconds of the game and the Knights are on the board.
For Brooke Watson, and here comes the press. And how's McNaughton gonna handle it? They handle it really well, but a block shot from Beach.
And Sammy hustles down.
Inside, and they beat everybody down the floor. Look at that. This is gonna be fun, end-to-end stuff. And the McNaughton Highlanders will get into their starting lineup because they are no slouch. They got some real good players. Struggled in their first game, but came back nicely in game number two. And look at, she does stuff the kids just don't do at this age. Mm-hmm. Tucking that ball like a football.
Absolutely, yeah, protecting the rock.
Not something that comes
through coaching at this level, yeah.
Right? Like, that is something she has worked on herself and mastered, and just, and she needs that. Like, until she gets that right hand as a more dominant hand, especially when she goes to the next level, she's going to need to split defenses like that with her strength.
Ella McNally with an important
rebound there by Ella McNally, for sure. 3-0 early. Pushing the pace.
Reese Tunn. Off the board and in.
Wow. She seemed to be going a little bit out of control, but she's got some pretty good touch. At that top speed is Reese Tunn, and she's one of the big contributors to the McNaughton offense. Beach misses a jumper, but Reese on the push. Inside it goes to Haley Campbell. Back out to Olivia Kickert, who's had a good tournament, but turns it over to Black. And we've seen that.
She won't make any mistake there, Elaine.
Over and over and over again in this tournament. And there it is again, another turnover. And Kickert.
Yeah, the hustle and the intensity is there from the girls right off the jump.
And if you let Moncton High get that much momentum going, it feels like you're just running uphill constantly with that press. Mm-hmm. Just pestering you all game. Brooke Watson, so tough with the ball. Foul on Olivia Mowat. Moncton, as they have on pretty much everybody in this tournament, has the experience advantage with those seniors across the board.
Smart move by Brooke Watson. Seeing that her defender was going up, she cut down to the hoop.
Nice pass, nice 1-2 pass. Giving Amadou a wide open jumper, just comes up short. And Bernice McNaughton will get another chance. So, Ella McNally keying it in. We haven't really gone through. It's Reese Mann and they split that real well. See what decision McNally makes. Oh, just fumbled away a little bit there at the last second by Abby McIntosh. And before you know it, they're down at the rim, but rebounded by Mowat, and she's going to push. And she's got Haley Campbell with her, but she pulls it back out, waits, and oh, just a little too far for Abby McIntosh. So missed opportunities a little bit here early for Harris, for Bernice McNaughton. Look at that one too, again, just, wow, a little too unselfish there maybe. Passed up two wide open shots, did Moncton. That probably was the third best shot they could have taken on that possession. Ella McNally, cross court to Reese Mann. Defended there. Mann going across the lane. Gets bailed out a little bit. That would have been a tough shot.
Yeah, absolutely. She's lucky she got fouled there. She's going to be right at the line for two. Yeah. Reese Mann.
So we sang the praises of the Moncton starting lineup, and now, of course, we have to give some credit to McNaughton for getting here to these crossovers. What does McNaughton do pretty well as a team that got them here?
Yeah, McNaughton moves the ball well. You'll see that they're quick to beat the press through the middle and push the ball up the floor, which is really going to be crucial in this game. And we'll see how good they shoot, too, because Reese Mann just knocked down two there. And I think shooting the ball and taking the opportunities when they're there is going to be crucial for McNaughton's success against the Knights.
Watson. Pushing again, just that's tough to squeeze out a layup between three Highlanders like that. Mowat pushes, Reese Mann steps in, misses the jumper. It's gonna be McNaughton ball, 5-4 here early. McNaughton hanging with the Knights. Not sure the discussion going on there. Coach Troy McKenzie on the sideline.
Just making sure the right player had the foul, I think.
Okay. And, oh, good cut there by Mann. Good kick out. And on the bounce, Haley Campbell gets fouled. So, talk about the toughness of Moncton High. Bernice McNaughton's got some tough characters to deal with as well. Ella McNally had a great second game after she struggled the first game. We'll see if she carries that momentum through here, and Mowat was our player of the game the first game.
Mowat's a player I think the Highlanders are really going to look for in this game. She's a tough player and she's aggressive, and I think through her ball handling and ability to get to the hoop will be crucial this game if she can perform well.
Yeah, and she had well cut off there. Mowat on the drive by Black. And Reese Mann off to Mowat. Drives the lane, does Mowat, throws up a wild one, and Amadou sticking her nose in, squeezing that. Kick ahead pass from DeVarin all the way across.
Lindsey Black will take three.
Black will take three from Beach, and look at the hustle there. Brooke Watson thought she won possession, but no, coming back to McNaughton. McNally going to key in to Mann. Haley Campbell on one wing and Mowat on the other. Trapped out there. Good work from Moncton High. Here comes Black to Watson.
She's fouled hard.
She's going to go to the line. And Reese Mann with her. Somebody just texted me, Reese Mann. I must have been saying somebody else's name. Good grief. I called it a left brain hip check earlier. I've been like superimposing people's names. People, this is my sixth game of the day. I do six games tomorrow, and I've done all the games this week. So if I happen to say something dumb, just, you know, chalk it up to one of those things. I know Reese Mann's name. I must have said something silly. Reese's Pieces. I'll just call her that.
Yeah, we could call her that.
I'll just
sure
call her that
it.
The rest of the weekend. So Kelly, get off my back, Vass. And there's Mowat on the baseline. In and out, and back to Moncton. And it's interesting that McNaughton's extending their defense against Moncton. And that's a dead ball foul. Not good. McNally, you want to use your fouls a little more judiciously than that. Mm-hmm. And that's only her first, though, so that's good news. But do you think that's good strategy for McNaughton to be extending their defense against a quick and deadly attack from Moncton High in the open court. I don't know if I'd...
Yeah, I'm okay with it in the first quarter. I think Coach Murray can kind of get the feel if it's going to be beneficial to her team or not. But after... See how it goes in the first quarter. If it's not working, I'd be pretty quick to pull it off. I don't want to get my girls too tired here early in the game against a very quick night team.
Yeah. And 2 for 2 at the line for DeVarin. She's got a nice shot. Does DeVarin, a real good complimentary player to the guards
good
and other
hands by Sammy.
Guards in the backcourt. And Sammy Amadou is just a menace defensively. They have, it's like, it's a really good mix, like the backcourt that they have, and then they got Beach in the front court who's a really good player to play. She's like an ideal, she sets really good screens, can hit an open shot when it's created for her too. They've got perfect role players to go with kind of the big scorers
a well-rounded team.
Yeah, yeah. It's nice to have a well-rounded team, but they just seem to mesh together so well. And Sammy, like they all know they all know their role. Like Amadou is a hellacious defender and can also make an open shot if you leave her. And so it's good to have all these complementary pieces around. And that one goes down as well. 10-4 lead here, Moncton. Reese Mann pounds it on the left.
Oh, Lindsay Black will get picked up with a on the ball foul.
Troy McKenzie.
That's her second of the first.
Yep. You've already got two. He says, "You put me in a position. What are you putting me in this position for?"
You know what? On Wednesday night, I think she had two fouls quick in the game too, but it didn't faze her. So.
Yeah. Well, there's another left-handed layup on the break for Lindsay Black. Anyway, back to the action. She has had. That is the most common call I've made in this tournament so far. And to the break, and what's up with the scoreboard? That is not the right score. Something happened there. Oh well. So, there we go. Okay, there, it was just 12-4 instead of 4-2. Okay, so, yeah, I don't know if I'm the Bernice McNaughton coach right now, it's all about the same thing it was in their first game. Terrible start. Turnovers.
Seems to be a little bit of a pattern here for McNaughton, but
yeah, if they're not turning the ball over, they get good shots.
Mm-hmm.
And it's either good shot or turnover, nothing in between. So Moncton, they got to fix things, and they got to fix things right now. Because right now, it's still, we've seen this pattern in this tournament too many times. Teams letting teams get away, and then, you know, they wake up in the second quarter down 20.
It makes it a pretty big hole to dig yourself out of.
It makes it too big a hole to dig out of, exactly. So McNaughton, this veteran Moncton High team, they got the offensive talent to keep up, but they got to take care of that rock.
Yeah, I'd say the Knights are feeling pretty confident right now. You see all five of them out there ready for the Highlanders to come on out.
Yep, they're waiting. And Kickert went to the bench pretty quick, and I don't know if she'll get back out there in the near future, but she went to the bench awfully quick, did Kickert. She's been an effective backcourt, steady backcourt presence for McNaughton.
There's Mowat getting up.
Very nice pass from Mann to Mowat. And rebounded in there by Ella Smith, who's had a pretty good tournament for McNaughton. Staying here. And Abby McIntosh will get it in for McNaughton. Into the corner. Mowat back out to Smith. Into Mowat. Fumbles, but picks it back up again. Comes up a little bit short. Follows her shot. But rebounded there by Black, and she's going to push. Look at that
good
pass
vision
from
by
Watson
Brooke Watson.
To DeVarin running the other way, running the other lane. Pretty stuff from Moncton. That backcourt, quick. Mann's going to launch a three. Comes up short. Squeezed there by Rachel Beach. Coming the other way is Brooke Watson. What's option she going to choose? Always the right one.
I can't get over Brooke Watson's vision and her ability just to see the court right with two girls on her, and she just jumps up and makes the right play what seems like every time.
And she can pass it with both hands, which is always effective. And Reese Mann
responds with a three.
A big one from Mann. Brings it back 16-7, but here comes Watson on the run. Again, right choice, Amadou, but that one too late.
One too many passes there.
Absolutely. Shoot it or bring it back out. On the attack is Mowat. met there at the rim by DeVarin. Straight up, no foul. Watson pushes. Met nicely there by Abby McIntosh.
Dribbles it off her foot.
Yeah, well done there by Abby McIntosh. That belly up D on Watson forces a turnover, a rare one from her. Kamara Foster into the game. Sorry, Kamara. Kamara Foster into the game. Pardon me, Kamara. I know a Kamara. It's victimized me before. Up the floor to
Watson away for her team. Yep. She gathers.
Black. Over to Beach. Watson. Nice kick to the corner. DeVarin. Free. Yawn. Oh, I guess a long two that one was. But so crisp and together is that Purple Knight offense. Oh, nicely done inside to Smith, but picked off by Black. And here comes Moncton again on the run. Black's going to attack. Cut off well, though.
Good defense by the Highlanders.
Really nicely done by a combination of Mowat and Mann. Mm-hmm.
That's going to be a big thing for the Highlanders, just to have the discipline to not reach in on the Knights' layups here in this game. They'll want to stay out of foul trouble because the Knights seem to be a pretty good free throw shooting team.
And not the best player maybe on Moncton High, but my favorite player on Moncton High, I think, is Emma Dunnett. She's been so good. She's so vocal defensively, so good defensively. Rebounds, shoots the ball a little bit, moves the ball well. Just one of those, like,
hustle key players. Knows her role and plays it well.
Oh, man. It's been so good. I just like how heads up she is and how into the game. Always talking. Always in the right spot. And a baseline, a double dribble there from Foster. Wanted to kick it inside, but it was shut down and got herself a little out of control. DeVarin gets it in. always asking to push it is Troy McKenzie. No matter what the speed is, they're moving. He wants them to go faster. And Black, the pass hits the bottom of the rim. And Black almost steals it from Mowat, but she's going to get another foul.
That's no good for the Knights.
And that's three before the end of the first.
70 feet from the rim. You don't need to be having those fouls this early in the game.
You don't. And Troy McKenzie, now we've seen this every game. Somebody, a key player on one of the teams, saddled with two, three early fouls. The guys' games and the girls' games. These weird patterns we've seen this week continue with the hoop.
The confidence that Troy has in Lindsey Black, though, is phenomenal. That he's letting one of his star wing players stay in the game with three fouls early in the first. Yeah. It says a lot about the confidence he has in her.
Yeah, saying you better figure it out. Look at that double team there from Brooke Watson. Forces another turnover from McNaughton. I'm wondering if Amadou's going to come in for Black.
Yeah, there
and she
it
is.
I think that's the right call there.
Yeah. You want to show confidence, but you also realize a spot in the Hoop Classic is on the line. Okay. There's 1 second off the. Get the shot clock correct. Brooke Watson in. McNaughton still putting pressure on, still extending the defense. Mowat does a terrific job on Watson on that one, though. Amadou puts it on, crosses over into the lane, and nice kick to the corner. And Watson.
Brooke Watson will knock it down.
Like, you know, it's so many people that can do so many things offensively for Moncton.
Rachel Beach with the block inside.
Beach with the block, but a nice play there.
And Mowat.
Leah Smith.
Mowat will throw it up and get herself two shots at the line.
There you go. That was well done by Leah Smith. She realized there might be an opportunity there. She saved it, and she saved it right to Mowat. And Mowat, a tough take. And McNaughton finding themselves in a big hole here before the end of the first quarter. 21-7 now, 2:06 left, first quarter. And a miss for Mowat. She's got one more. It's up and through. 21-8 now. Sub coming in. Ella McNally back in for Foster. McNally's had a slow start to her game. She was very effective in game two for McNaughton. Brooke Watson just picking them apart. There's a kick to, oh, back to Watson inside.
Good ball movement by the Knights.
To Beach and back out to Amadou and back to DeVarin.
They gotta get a
Beach
shot up here.
And they're not gonna get one.
Mowat will pick it away and go down to the other end off 2 feet.
And she's
up
gonna
strong,
get hammered
and she'll
down.
Go to the line for two.
Almost finishes. Does Mowat? Not quite. She's got two.
Mowat did an excellent job there getting to 2 feet and bracing the contact. She knew she had two guards on her and wanted to be able to finish strong, so she was able to go up.
And if McNaughton can win these last couple of minutes, feel a little bit better about their tough start. Got one of Moncton's best players in foul trouble. They're back within 11. They can get a couple stops here to end the quarter. They got Mowat on Watson, but she splits him.
Yeah,
now
Brooke Watson splits him right now.
Look at Mowat get back. Oh, that looked like a pretty clean tie-up. Oh, boy, bad luck for McNaughton there. Not much of an argument from the bench or from Mowat, but
I think the foul was on the floor, but she'll get two at the line since we're in bonus.
Yep. Watson's going to make pretty high percentage of these free throws. That makes her even tougher to handle. Yeah, Mowat, her second. So she's got to watch herself because she's obviously somebody that McNaughton's looking for to defend that backcourt. Reese Mann, three's not there. Over to Mowat, puts the ball on the floor with one bouncing up and a good shot, but it's missed. Anamadou cleans the glass. DeVarin is going to push, gets it to Watson. She's going to go back to DeVarin. Swing up top to Amadou. She's going to drive with the right hand. And gets called for a travel. Well cut off there by Mann and Mowat. So some good defensive and offensive possessions here by the Highlanders, but they got to string them together against this high-powered Moncton offense. It's pushing the ball every opportunity and creates a turnover. And here goes Watson. And she sees her to the left, but she doesn't take it. That would have been better served to pull it out, I think. Didn't quite have it. That was 2-on-4. Reese Mann over to Mowat. Back to McNally. Over to Mann. Into the corner. Smith drives. Nice take. Wide open for Mowat. Pretty stuff.
Excellent shot.
And a long two there by McNaughton. But that was their best offensive possession of the night so far. Everybody touched it. And a rare Brooke Watson turnover for Moncton High at the feet of Amadou. No chance to catch it there. So last possession, chance to cut it under 10 with the Highlanders. Reese Mann goes off the Mowat screen. It's gonna stay here with the Highlanders. Physical D there again from Emma Dunnett.
I think the Highlanders will wanna use the clock here all 16 seconds and get one shot off.
That'd be smart to do so. Moncton, you'd leave that much time on the clock.
Kicks it over to Reese Mann in the corner for Olivia Mowat.
Oh,
comes
that's
up
good
short.
Offense, but Mann follows. Just doesn't get it, doesn't bank it home, and it's going to go back to Moncton.
See if Brooke Watson can throw in a little.
Right? Would you put it past her?
No, absolutely not. Oh, it's going to be late.
Late
she's too strong.
But end of first. Moncton High, 23. McNaughton Highlanders, 12. And if I'm McNaughton, I'm looking at things going, okay, I started off pretty terrible, but we got it almost back within 10, and we've got one of the best players in the province, and the key to all they do defensively and offensively on the bench with three. If I'm the coaches of the Highlanders, I'm talking about this is our time. If we're going to get back in the game, it's right now. Mm-hmm. So what do you think the communication is on the McNaughton bench?
I think just from what I heard Dale Murray say that she liked her girls to take off their press. So I think they might be getting a little tired and letting their legs go on them. So it would be pretty smart of them to start picking up at half and playing hard half-court defense. So their offense has to come from their D. So if they can get a couple defensive stops and a couple steals and come down to the other end, a couple stop and scores, then that's what the Highlanders are going to need here to be successful in this half.
Yeah, because Brooke Watson, whether it was against with that pushed up defense. I mean, Brooke Watson was just splitting them and getting to the middle of the floor and doing whatever she wanted there. I mean, it wasn't terribly effective. I mean, Moa did a pretty good job on her there, a mano, but Moncton would, you know, run somebody through or send a kind of a even just a dummy screen at her. She was able to split that defense and get up the floor pretty easy. So I think McNaughton's going to be better served because they got some stalwart defenders.
Absolutely, and they do have a very strong press. That isn't to say that McNaughton's press wasn't doing the job, but it's very hard when you have offensive players such as Brooke Watson and other players in this league, as we saw Kate Fillmore over on Trimble, which is another team that McNaughton will have to face this season. But when you got star guards like that, press is hard to make work. So I think it's going to be a smart decision for the Highlanders to start picking up at half here.
Yeah. Ava Dixon on the floor for the Highlanders, making her first appearance. I know her parents pretty well. Matt and Heather, hi guys, if you're watching, hope you are. DeVarin misses a three. Rebound in there by Mann, and she didn't see Sammy Amadou coming, and she paid the price. Amadou cut her off. She fumbled the ball right into the hands. right into the hands of Emma Dunnett. She put it home. 25-12, Moncton. Dixon gathers on the wing. Squares up, goes baseline. Oh, just stepped on the baseline. She had Kickert there in the corner to kick to, but was squeezed out by Moncton High. And here comes Brooke Watson. And nice give. Look at that from Beach. Good stuff from DeVarin. Hard foul from Reese Mann. Here's me thinking, oh, McNaughton's really smart. You know, you can't do the press and then they pick you apart. They just get to the high post to Beach, skilled big, who can just drop dimes like that to DeVarin.
Excellent shot there.
Yeah, she's got a really sweet shot.
Quick release.
Yeah. Follows
tracks
her own shot.
Down.
Oh, is there anything worse as a coach than a offensive rebound on a missed free throw? No, there isn't, is the answer to that question. I'll answer for you. Kickert back in the game. Misses that shot off, and oh, we just fumbled out of bounds by Dunnett. It's going to stay with McNaughton. And Dixon will key it in.
A little miscommunication there with
the referee.
Whistle.
Yeah, I don't know why exactly he blew the whistle, but threw everybody off there for a second.
Go off of McIntosh's hands.
Yeah, and that's not a turnover you like if you're a Highlander fan. On an inbounds, Brooke Watson setting things up off the Beach. Makes good decisions, good dribble handoff action there with DeVarin. Into the corner for Dunnett, she's going to pop it too, and it's in. They just got people that can make shots all over the floor to Moncton High. Reese Mann inside to Dixon, just a little high for her. And that's what Moncton does. So solid defensively on the perimeter. They speed you up. They don't give you a chance. And Reese Mann did not give Dixon a realistic chance to catch that ball. Didn't create the space that Dixon needed to post up. Brooke Watson now. Samia Amadou, hand off to DeVarin. Oh, and a little
too many dribbles there for the Knights.
Miscommunication there. All right. Now Mowat initiating the offense for the Highlanders. Dixon. Carved out some pretty good space there. That was right. That was pretty good job by Ava Dixon there. Making Dunnett climb over her back. Much better job there by the Highlanders. Abby McIntosh now back in the game, gonna key it in. Dixon to the corner, collects. Swings the ball to McNally, drives the lane, in and out. But McNaughton crashing the ball, the boards, and Kickert comes out of there with it, but it's gonna be knocked out of off of her leg by Dunnett. The Bulldog done it again. Gets him a new possession. Nice dribble handoff action again. Just missed there by Brooke Watson, but you love that stuff they run through Beach at the high post, eh?
Absolutely, yeah. It's really good to see the ball go into the post and the high post there, and the girls be able to play off of it.
I mean, she's a real big body there and down low, but she's also got some skill. Handoff, little dribble handoff stuff, and you can trust her to handle the ball at that high post.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Knights run that horns action that we had talked about in the previous game about getting two posts in the elbows, and I think it'd be really good to see Rachel Beach catch the ball and square up after her point guard goes off and just knock in a couple bangers from the free throw line.
Yeah, look at those. They just ran about 50 screens off of Beach. And if I'm her, I'm going, okay, you run all those screens. Can I have a touch now? So us guards are so selfish. We love those big people to set their screens for us. We don't want to give them the ball, though. God, we're terrible. Beach back to Brooke Watson. A few too many steps there. I think she wanted Dunnett in the corner. And a Highlander got in her line of vision, and she's going to come out a little frustrated. She is so hard on herself as Watson, playing at such a high level and just wants to do everything perfect. Kicker looks to go baseline. Not there. McNally. She's going to try to go right and spin. Spins back. Kicker with a jump shot. Comes up short. Dunnett's there.
And they'll see Sammy over the top.
Sammy goes long. She drives left. Can't finish. Knocked away. DeVarin collects. New onto the floor is Apthorpe for Moncton High. Grade 10 kid. Beach follows, not able to get it to go. Oh, nice fake there from Smith on the wing. Gets it back out to Mowat. Mowat's going to swing it. Nope. She's looking for something to get set up.
She'll take it herself.
She did. She saved it.
Kept alive.
She did.
Ella McNally puts it up.
Misses, and there's Amadou. Oh, yes, okay. Yep, didn't hit the rim on the first attempt, so that should have been a 24-second violation. Referees realized it. And Mowat and McIntosh go to the bench. Into the game for the Highlanders is Jada Matchett. And swing, goes that ball in the Moncton High offense. Dunnett looking for Amadou. Amadou going to drive left-handed.
Oh, gets called for the offensive foul.
Not so sure about that one. Looks like
a little too much use of the armbar.
Maybe. I don't know. I'm not so sure myself.
No, I'm not saying I agree
with
that.
I've done that a few times. And if I got that call, I'd put up a stink.
I think that's what Troy was saying over there on the sidelines. So having this girl's back.
Troy's giving me one of those, or two, or three, or ten in men's league. The ward off. Oh, that pass put Beach into trouble. She had no chance to gather that.
Yeah, she was moving pretty fast when they threw the ball to her. She didn't have any chance to gather. And
yeah, you don't want to throw. You don't want to throw your big person a pass like that in the lane. It's just not fair. So Moncton High now firmly in control of this game, 28-12.
As Coach Dale Murray takes another timeout.
Yep. So, this one is getting a little bit out of McNaughton's hands, and without without Black on the floor, the lead's only getting extended, which is bad news for the Highlanders.
Good to see if you're a Knight fan, though. Know that the bench can come off and make a difference for the Knights as well.
Yeah, a lot of depth in the Moncton High bench. So
not a very big bench, but the five girls that they do have are key players when they get on there.
Everybody can play. So we'll take this opportunity to mention to you guys Watts Leasing, one of the sponsors of the DNA Swag Hoop Classic on the ladies' side. They're a locally owned company specializing in the rental and leasing of all types of transportation and storage equipment. They're thrilled to be a part of the 2021 DNA Swag Hoop Classic, and we're thrilled to have Watts Leasing as a sponsor. So thanks to Watts Leasing. thanks to all the sponsors, Crandall University, DNA Swag, everybody involved on the girls and guys side. And McNaughton has 5 minutes now, 5 minutes and 29 seconds here to try to close this gap before halftime. You got to figure Lindsey Black's going to be back on the court at the start of the second half, but Reese Mann gets called for the travel, that palming violation. Trying to go at Amadou. Amadou's tough hombre on the defensive end of the floor. Done it. Puts her head down and knocks somebody to the floor. Shocking surprise. Amadou dances in with the left hand, just can't finish. Smith with a nice rebound and a push up to Kickert. Kickert, not there inside, pulls it back out. McNally on the drive. Blocked there by Beach. Beach, stalwart defensively. Done it. Into the key with the right hand.
I thought Dunnett was going to throw up a nice alley-oop pass to the young Kennedy. Athletic Kennedy there could have grabbed it.
You think so?
Yeah.
I'd like to see it. If anybody could complete it, I'd trust Dunnett. Oh, good skip pass there by Reese Mann. She was stuck but got rid of it. Good strength there. Kickert can put one up. Misses to the right. And the body language of McNaughton, they need somebody to pick them up a little bit. Get them going, because they are looking a little bit discouraged.
Yeah, they'll need a big play here, turn it around and get some energy.
Yeah, not hard to blame them. I mean, this is a tough squad to play against. Apthorpe ripped away by Dunnett down on the baseline, but misses and ripped away here by Kickert. She's going to push the pace. She's going to go all the way with the right hand, and she's going to go to the line. Kennedy Apthorpe on the foul. So good push there by Kickert. They need a little bit of energy and need a little bit of push from somebody here towards the end of the second quarter, just to get a little bit of good feeling going into halftime.
Yeah, it'd be nice to see the Highlanders get on a little bit of a run here going into the half.
Yeah. We root for the underdogs around here. And the underdogs are whoever's losing at the moment.
It does seem to change quickly, though.
That's how it goes with us. We want everybody to win. We're a bunch of saps around here. We want everybody to do well. Sorry about that. Beach kicks it out. Look at that. Done it. Oh, and a nice rejection by
Ella Smith.
Love it. And Kickert on the push again, but look at Sammy Amadou. No thanks. Not while I'm on the court. Amadou moves her feet so well. And plays without fouling. She's really unassuming. I haven't seen her expression change, Amadou, through three games.
She's there to get the job done.
She just plays.
Dunk it.
And she's
come on.
Oh, she wanted Beach to get one.
Yeah, just too nice.
She was with me. Yeah. She's like, hey, get my big girl a touch. Nice rebound and put back from Beach. Reese Mann over to Kickert. Nice drive baseline by Kickert. Up top to... And up it goes for McNally for three, but short. Good box out by Amadou. And it goes to Apthorpe, and she's going to push. The grade 10. Nice swing. Oh, and Watson got her feet ahead of her head a little bit. And traveled. And new reinforcements in for McNaughton. Kamara Foster in, and Mowat back in. Olivia Mowat for McNaughton. As well as Ava Mitten on the floor for McNaughton now. Mowat looking for a cutter. Kamara Foster.
Fancy crossover
that
by
Mowat. That was pretty.
Mowat finishes the shot.
Absolutely. And good movement there by McNaughton, even away from the ball. Nice cut. Took the attention away from Mowat as she made that move. And that look broken up inside.
Yeah, that's what I'm talking about there. I like to see Rachel Beach catch it in the post and score up to the hoop.
Yeah, absolutely.
She'll see lots more opportunities for herself that way.
Mowat, almost a tough finish over top of that Moncton High inside defense, but no good. And here comes Brooke, and she gets it to Apthorpe. Oh, good shot from Apthorpe, but in and out. Well rebounded there by Mann. Good box out for McNaughton. And there's Ava Mitten running wide. She gets that ball knocked away, and that's going to be a travel.
Brooke Watson forces
Brooke
the
Watson,
turnover.
Yeah. The hands, active hands from Moncton. Always digging. Kennedy Apthorpe into Brooke Watson. Watson. There's Beach. Doesn't square up, just hand off again. Apthorpe up to Beach. Nice pass in the corner. Good find from Beach, but a little long has done it. Reese Mann running the floor well. She's gonna try to go baseline. Oh, just, she still had that live dribble. She should have gone all the way. Who will go all the way is Brooke Watson, laying it in. She's a one-person fast break for Moncton High most of the time. Mowat dances into the key and just misses that foul line jumper, but maintains possession. Just Amadou just got the tip on. And again trying to save it. Good effort there from McNaughton to maintain possession. But do you talk about with your JV girls the importance of getting, just getting hands on balls defensively? Because
absolutely, having active hands and hands up is key to any deflection. So, just being in the right defensive position is something that we focused on, and being in help side and in the gaps is crucial.
Right, and in the NBA and WNBA now, they actually keep stats on deflections.
Oh, right on.
And what teams, yeah, and what teams have the most, and it really is an indicative of how
they're tracking all kinds of neat things now.
They are, and that is really indicative of how strong your defense is, your deflection rate, because that it puts the offense at a disadvantage. They got to take it out of bounds. They got to reset it. It doesn't allow them to keep flow. All that stuff, right? So, even if you don't get a steal, a deflection means a lot. And Amadou dances across the lane for two again on the feed by Beach. They can run everything through that big stalwart Beach there in the middle. And a good kick there to Dixon. Or Mitten, pardon me. Back up to...
Big board for Apthorpe.
Yeah, and she comes flying in, does the grade 10.
She's someone that I would like to see be more confident and shoot the ball. She's going to have big shoes to fill in the next couple years as a grade 10 player playing on the varsity team. And I think with Lindsay Black graduating, she's going to be a player to step up in the next couple seasons. So
Apthorpe,
for her to get in now while Lindsay's in foul trouble and make some good plays would be an excellent confidence boost for her. She's an athletic player, and I think she's got a great stroke, so just need to see her shoot the ball more.
And she's got good size, eh? And long arms. Mm-hmm. She's probably going to grow a little bit more. Got to figure she's going to be a weapon for Moncton going forward because they need more of those. Nice cut. Look at that pass from up top from McNally.
And the hustle play by Mowat to pick it away on the inbounds.
And another hustle play, but Brooke Watson runs it down, and she carried the ball. Yep. Sharp
couple
eyes.
Turnovers by Brooke Watson here in the first half that we don't normally see.
Yep. She wanted to pass it, and then the lane was shut down, and she tried to dribble between them, and she got caught.
Highlanders will look for a shot here up at the top to end the half.
Oh, Apthorpe with a steal, and she'll dribble out the clock. And the half ends. McNaughton doubling up the Highlanders here with a spot in the DNA Swag Hoop Classic final on the line. 34-17. Going to halftime. And Moncton High, you got to be pleased. You're doubling up the Highlanders, and Lindsay Black spent most of the second quarter on the sidelines. And the Highlanders, you know, there's stuff you can take from it. Again, they are up against it, against a more experienced, deeper, older, bigger Moncton High squad. But there's things you can take away from the first half from them to go into the second.
Yeah, certainly. And I think we saw the press come off, and I think that was the right choice. But we also want to keep the intensity up. So if the Highlanders can get those second chance opportunities and continue going for their O boards, then that's going to make a big difference for them in the second half.
All right, fans. So we are going to take a quick break, and we will be back to you in about 9 minutes for half two. We'll see you then. Welcome back, fans, to the start of the second half. The McNaughton Highlanders are joining us late. They must have had a lot to say at halftime, the coaches to the players. Coming out late to start the second half for the Highlanders. Moncton's ready for them. We're ready for it to start. 34-17, the Moncton High Purple Knights over the McNaughton Highlanders. And before we get going, just in case, hopefully I catch you, Taya. Can I sing you a lullaby? Can we sing Taya a lullaby?
You can do that. I'm not much of a singer.
Good night, Taya. Have a good sleep, guy. We'll see you in the morning.
Get your beauty sleep, buddy.
Get your beauty sleep, man. You need it. So listen, this is a tall mountain for McNaughton to climb against a Moncton High team. And Moncton and Troy McKenzie, they had it wrong, whose ball it is, and then they went back and then they had it right again. So they got it right though, Moncton ball.
Yeah, and we'll see Lindsay Black back in the game for the Knights.
Yep, can she stay on the floor? Hopefully so. But McNaughton running a little zone here. And a miss lay-in from DeVarin, or pardon me, from Lindsay Black. But it's going to maintain possession for Moncton. So McNaughton, key is going to be to communicate out of this zone, if that's what they're still playing. Nope. Looks like they went back to man. Cut off there by Smith, and that's
big shot by Rachel Beach.
That's what she can give you. She's got some skill from that high post area. And Reese Mann. That pass is going the other way. You can see that coming a mile away. Brooke Watson just doesn't get the finish, though. Puts her hands up to her face.
She can't believe it.
I love her reaction. She's so expressive. She's just dying to do everything right. But it's not bad body language, though. Like, you don't look at her and go,
it's just her pouting. Yeah,
she's just expressive.
Yeah.
And look at that. Gets down and gets a steal again.
Hustle
back-to-back
player.
Possessions.
Slows it down. See Sammy open. Sammy drives and has it picked away.
That vision is so good, right? Like, as a point guard, you know she's got such good sense. She knows it's in the corner. She doesn't know Amadou's there. She just senses it out of the corner of her eye because she knows what her partners.
Yeah, these girls have played together for so long, so they have excellent chemistry on the floor, and it's really showing in this tournament.
McNally throws up a wild one, but it's rebounded by Smith, and Amadou on the hold to Troy McKenzie. Speaking of expressive.
He's definitely one for the two,
Jim Carrey didn't do that many reactions. And oh, no, I'm dating myself. I'm not going to finish that sentence. Good grief. All right, Amadou digs it out. Up to Brooke and see what decision she makes. Goes to the right, kicks it to Black. Fires it in there to Sammy. Missed hook there for two. DeVarin looking for the ball, doesn't get it. Back come the Highlanders. Haley Campbell.
Active hands by Brooke Watson. Beautiful lob pass
and
up to Black.
Yawn.
And a left-handed layup for Lindsay Black.
Oh, I'm sorry, Lindsay. It's just you've done it so many times.
You're just so good at it,
so
Lindsay.
So boring at this point. Do something else. Throw it down or something. Oh, that worked out for the Highlanders, but a little bit of a panic underneath there by McNally. She had more time than she thought. Didn't finish. Nice little shovel pass to Watson, but misses. Black, though, digs out their offensive rebound underneath to DeVarin. And look at that ball sharing there. Brooke Watson.
Going to the line for two.
Off the feed from Beach. I'm with you. I want Beach to shoot more. Right?
Mm-hmm. Square
She's
up.
Just square up and look. She's just like, no, I'm going to let my guard score all the points. I'm good. I'll just be over here blocking shots and getting rebounds and setting screens and dribble handoffs and dropping dimes. And hate to see such unselfishness. It's really, really ugly.
Excellent. Oh, board by Sammy.
Right. Oh, look at that feed. Nice. From Black. Faked that shot. Found DeVarin. Gee, weird. Sammy Amadou tying somebody up. That never happens.
Haley Campbell goes down hard there.
Yeah,
shakes it off.
She had to rip it through. Did Campbell. Good fight from her. Bang that knee pretty good. And Reese Mann into Oh, gets called for a travel first. Just a tough night for McNally. Indicative of her, really goes back to her first game. She just didn't get anything going. Talented player, just struggling a little bit tonight. Saw what she could do in the second game. Think it's more indicative of how she can normally play. And a good... so expressive is true. And let's talk about... I'm not sure. He must have made a remark to his player. It sounded like snide and sarcastic.
Coach Troy McKenzie will get
to Rich Caulfield.
Technical foul.
Didn't hear what he said.
I don't think he really cared.
He didn't.
Didn't faze him at all. He wanted to talk to Brooke Watson. Hey, ref, let me talk to my point.
He may have wanted it. I'm not sure what he said to get it. But coaches these days have to be. You can't just, back in my day, if you wanted to take a tech to make a point to the referee during a game, you could. Nowadays, if they accumulate technical fouls, you start looking at suspensions.
Yeah.
And that is not something you want as a coach.
Although Leo St. Pierre could take over, eh?
Yeah. probably be better off, really, let's be honest. Just kidding, Troy. And, you know, whatever. Yeah. You know, just happened. I don't feel like saying it again.
Assistant coach Leo St. Pierre, she was quite the all-star in her day. Played in the Hoop Classic back in 2008.
One of the best players I've ever seen.
Excellent. Yeah, absolutely.
There's just no way around
it.
Yeah,
she played over at Matthew Martin, and then she transferred to McNaughton, actually. So she's playing against her old stomping grounds here.
Yeah, and she, speaking of somebody that could do it all, Leah St. Pierre could do it all. Great defensive player. Oh, another turnover. Reese Mann, just McNaughton, no rhythm to their offense. Can't connect plays together. It's a staunch Moncton High veteran defense they're going up against. But I love the spirit. Reese Mann up top still calling out plays, screaming ball, talking. They're not losing their spirit, McNaughton, or their effort, but it is just a difficult team to play against, this Moncton High team. But nice box out there by McNally. Well done by her. Fighting off DeVarin. And runs a screen up there up top. Abby McIntosh to the corner to Reese Mann. Sammy Amadou steps right in, takes it back. And Black is going to go to the rim. And that's where her being more comfortable with the right hand would certainly come in handy, wouldn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I even saw her go with the footwork for a left-handed layup there on the right side.
You did. But 42-18 now. Moncton High creeping closer to securing a spot in the Hoop Classic final. Tomorrow, awaiting them in a little bit of an upset from earlier, we thought, the St. Malachy Saints.
That gold medal game's going to be an intense game tomorrow.
Yeah. So good news for St. Max is you get 2 extra hours break than Moncton High does. Sounds like you need the sleep after traveling back and forth and playing some games in the middle of this tournament. So if you're listening, St. Max, we're very impressed by your comeback victory in the first game.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised if they're going to be listening to this game tomorrow morning, if they do a little pregame routine with Coach Dan Patterson and go over who they're going to be facing in the final. They might even be watching this game live tonight. So
yeah.
Great game, girls, if you're listening. It was a well-fought game, and we're happy to see you come back from a deficit and finish the game strong.
Yeah, we were impressed. And Grace Collins, if you're listening, you were our pick for player of the game. That is no shot at the player who was picked.
Clancy had an excellent game,
Clancy,
too.
Clancy, you were terrific. But we wanted to shout out Grace because she was frustrating the Harrison Trimble Trojans on the defensive glass. They didn't really find an answer for her all night on the glass or for a lot of those St. Malachy Saints. So
as Lindsay Black goes 2 for 2 from the line.
They're pesky, and they're looking at this Moncton High squad going, where are the holes in this defense that we can exploit? Not many, but we underestimated them yesterday. Earlier today. We thought maybe the Trojans would come out on top, so might be crazy to underestimate them again, but Lindsey Black with a left-handed layup. It almost doesn't sound like words anymore. You know how you say a word over and over again? It sounds like nonsense.
It riddles off your tongue now.
Yeah. Oh, a nice move there from Mowat. Oh, it just comes up short.
Good board. Let's go.
Push the ball. You don't have to tell them twice. And she's going to spin back to her left. Yeah, that was coming a mile away. Even if you see it coming, though, you don't necessarily able to do anything about it. She has such good body control. Nice give and go to Mann.
I thought Sammy might have been straight up there, but.
Yep, it was.
Oh, excellent, nice.
Yep. Just automatic down there, Zamadou. I've had a strong wish all week that we had an all-defensive team to pick for these tournaments. Mm-hmm. I'm going to lobby for that next year. We should have all defense.
Yeah, I know the Royals back probably about 5 or 6 years ago, their coach actually came up with a defensive player for each game, so they got to wear a special jersey for their girls. So
Ooh.
In this hoop classic, you'd see girls walking around with a jersey on, knowing that they were the best defensive player of their game.
Nice. Kicker comes up short on a three. I like that she took it, though. She's wide open. She could shoot that shot. Just not on their game today is McNaughton. So end of the game there for the Highlanders is Brooklyn McKay, grade 10 player for McNaughton, getting her some minutes. And also a grade 10 player in up front for Moncton, Mia Allman. Big, big player. Lots of potential. Girl that size. Well done there by McNally.
Mills will pick up a foul.
Yep.
Or is that Hamilton, sorry? Hamilton, Emily Hamilton will pick
Emily
up a
Hamilton.
Foul.
New into the game, as well as Rebecca Mills in for Moncton High. Grade 11 player inside to McNally. Reese Mann in the corner, and they had two people running to the same spot, so a little crowded there. Turned over by McKay.
With this new lineup too, Troy's resorted to a zone defense for his Knights.
Yep, good job there.
It's gonna give the Highlanders an opportunity to attack gaps and shoot the ball.
Yep. Good job there by McNally. Another deflection out of bounds. Back on the court, too, is Emma Dunnett from Moncton High. And the Mills back up top to Apthorpe. She's going to put it on the bounce. Swiped away by Reese Mann. Well done. Kicker collects and goes. She's going to try to go all the way. I think she saw Mia Allman coming, got a little bit scared.
Really good offensive play by Olivia Mowat, though, to get in front of number 23 and hold her back.
Oh, and a good knockaway there again by McNally. I like the effort from McNaughton. They're not letting any possession go to waste without a max effort. That's another deflection out of bounds by McNally. She's not giving up. Done it. Oh, and a nice
read by Ella McNally.
Nice pickoff by McNally going the other way. Oh, just a little bit too quick. Gets knocked away, but she recovers nicely. Over to Mann up top. Oh, and steps there. And turn back over. Brooklyn McKay. That's all right. Like the get the young kids in the game, let them make some mistakes.
Yep, it's a way to learn.
No harm done. In the corner, Reese Mann watching Mills. Knocked away. Like the activity defensively from McNaughton. You really got to respect. Look, 48 points towards the end of the third quarter for Moncton High. That's not a terrible defensive showing from McNaughton. They just have not been able to get anything going offensively at the other end. Because Moncton is swarming them. Done it up top. Apthorpe over to Mills. She's going to look baseline. Oh, nice look inside. Spins and misses Hamilton, but I like that pass. Oh,
ooh,
nice
Kickert
give off to.
Able to finish underneath.
Nicely done. Mowat to Kickert. Pretty play there in the open floor. Apthorpe bringing it up on the attack. have done it. Oh, she seals it. Nice kick out. Melman. Oh, and just a little bit off there by Apthorpe. You can see most of these, when they get these big leads, Moncton High, a lot of what they're trying to do is get those touches in there to Mia Ullman. Let her learn on the fly.
Yeah, she's certainly a big presence for them. So if you can get it into the post and play off that and use ball movement and swing, you're going to be really successful as a Knights offense.
This man with a nice spin there. Just misses. Back to kicker. Puts it up. Comes up short. Rebounded again by Mowat.
Risky save.
Yeah. You got to watch saving it under your own hoop. Try if you can to throw it back towards half court, if anything. Or eat it. Instead of giving up a layup. Oh, nice feed there. Kicker. A good move and a good crash there. The boards. Good fight for Mowat. Hamilton able to win that fight. Apthorpe into Allman again, and she's going to turn to the right and finish for two. Still not going over that left hand, over that left shoulder, but right now, does she really need to? So much size in there. Apthorpe pulls down the board. She'll take it back the other way. Oh, at the feet of Allman, that wasn't a good look. Going the other way is Kickert, and she's up and in. Oh, misses the layup, and we're going back the other way. Mills with some speed. Got some options. Off to Allman. Misses. Kickert back the other way.
Oh, good speed.
But Mills, look at that. Comes up again. Done it. Inside. Allman. Oh, just off the back of the rim. But hard working is Allman. Doesn't hang her head. Just gets back to the other end. Defensively. Man, on a spin. Nice kick to the corner. Kickert's got a three. Just off the side rim. Done it. Going back the other way.
Squeaked by her on the sideline.
Determined to get down there with the right hand. But turns it over. Kickert coming back the other way. She's going to make an attempt, but nicely done by Apthorpe, but she finishes through the contact.
Good defense, a better offense.
Yeah, Kickert. Couldn't ask much more from Apthorpe defensively there. Done it, pounds it right. Swings it back out to Mills. In there to Allman. She goes over her shoulder.
She makes no mistake this time, putting it high off the glass.
Nicely done by her. And a good feed there. Oh, done it, knocks it away. Man was pushing to Kickert. So all these teams will get one more game tomorrow, just a matter of how late in the day and how prestigious the trophy on the line. Reese Mann up for three and knocks it in.
With authority.
Absolutely. Nice shot from Mann. At the end of the third quarter, 52-25, Moncton High leads. And now it's pretty much over, but the last just playing this 10 minutes out, but Troy McKenzie out talking to his young guard, Kennedy Apthorpe.
Letting her know to slow it down coming up and finding the girls that are able to bring the ball up the floor. I think she tried to throw it at her big coming up, and I think it would have been better for her to kind of slow it down, get to 2 feet, and see the whole court.
Now, as a coach coming to a fourth quarter like this, if you got a big lead, typically what you want to do is you want to get your younger kids some playing time, but you also want to usually rotate in a couple of vets to give them a sure hand to kind of play off of.
Absolutely. As a coach, I would put in my younger players, but I'd also leave some of my stronger girls in there so that they didn't feel like they were left out to dry, kind of thrown under the bus without anyone able to step up and run the offense. So having a good two confident players on there and three younger girls is a great way to do it.
Yeah. So he's going to start the fourth, though, with five vets out there, starting lineup to start the fourth quarter. We'll probably see a few minutes of them, and then what we talked about, start shuffling in and out the bench, get them some more minutes. And over there is Reggie Caulfield demonstrating, the referee demonstrating for Mia Ullman some technique. I think he broke a hip there, just demonstrating it.
He is holding his hip.
Hopefully he's able to finish. Easy, Reg. Moncton keys it in. And on the floor again, Ava Dixon now for the Highlanders as they go to their bench a little bit. Oh, and a nice pass inside there for Lindsay Black, and she lays it in. Haley Campbell on the floor along with Abby McIntosh, kickers, Dixon, and Kamara Foster. Dixon puts it down on the right hand, hard drive. Might have got hit, but no call. Black runs it down. Turn back over to kickers. Kickers. Over to Foster. Oh, good feet inside. Oh, that was a good looking movement by McNaughton, but just fumbled out of bounds. Nice stuff by there. Haley Campbell flashing to the post. Finds Kickert in the corner, but just one of those plays. Come back at it. Sammy, hands off. For the lefty three.
Lindsay will knock in the three.
Yeah, Lindsay. She's
got
that.
She can do it all.
She's got that long range shot along with everything else. Kickert now. Using the screen from Dixon. Nice move inside, but met there by Beach. But a good bounce to Haley Campbell, who lays it in. Down the floor. Oh. Beach can't quite collect, and Dixon picks it off and gets fouled. Good defensive possession there by McNaughton. A little bit messy from Brooke Watson there, trying to go inside to Beach. Kickert here. Initiates things. Oh, she's going to try a three. It gets rejected by Black, and Watson up to Black, and that's a tough catch, but she manages anyway, but fumbles it out of bounds. And Watson's going again with those expressions. What am I doing? You dribble that one out. Wait for the secondary break is what you do there. Brooke, you've done it many times before. You'll do it again. High post again. Flash, not there. Oh, nice and nice look inside. Gets spun around by the Moncton defense, though. And Campbell and McIntosh trying to hook up there, just the size differential. Trying to go through that many hands.
McNaughton will have 10 seconds here to get a shot. As the Knights sub their entire bench in, all five on.
And that's what we figured might happen here. Mm-hmm. And they do have a couple of able vets to help out the rookies on the team. Mm-hmm. Certainly Dixon trying to hand off, and it's a shot clock violation. Didn't hear a countdown from the bench. You like to hear that. Let your girls know they got to get up a shot.
Certainly,
on
the glass. It's an easy way too for the bench to stay involved in the game, to be focused on the shot clock.
Yep. Apthorpe up top, looking inside for Alwyn. Sets a nice screen. Does Alwyn. Oh, across the lane comes Hamilton and loses it. Ava Dixon now on the push. She's going to try to go all the way.
And Apthorpe will get caught with the foul.
Yep. And she got lucky there because there was really no place to go down there, and Dixon really didn't have anybody across the court to hit that two on the baseline, so got bailed out a little bit. But hey, you push the pace sometimes, it works out for you. Dixon's got to have a shot at two shots at the line, misses the first.
She'll get one more shot to put some points up on the board for her team.
Little pat for McIntosh going. Come on, Ava. Misses the second.
Board there by Mills. She'll bring it up. Look to set up an offense.
And tough D there for McIntosh. Inside to Alwyn over the right shoulder again. Misses, but in there cleaning up is Emma Dunnett. She's going to bring it back out again. Up to Apthorpe. Into Alwyn, and she's got that over her left shoulder. And up and in for Alwyn. six quick ones for the grade 10. With good size.
Yeah, I wish they put their height in these rosters. I'd love to know how tall Elman is.
Right? Bigger than all the referees we've seen in this building, I think, this weekend. Oh, and a double trip from Dunn. She immediately knew it. Like, what am I doing? It's been the end of a long day. Emma, it's all right. You'll be better tomorrow. Laughing it off with the referee. Kickert initiates things. She's got McIntosh on her left. Goes to Dixon on her right. Dixon looks baseline. Cut off there. And a turnover. Apthorpe coming in for the double team. But Dixon staying with it. Nope. Got a foul. Thought she'd knocked it clean there on the steal. Right back. But gets hit. And back into the game is Ella Smith. For McNaughton.
The grade 9 from McNaughton, making a big appearance in this tournament.
Yep, she's looked pretty good. And again up for two goes Mia Allman. She's not a finished product yet, but one thing she's got is some touch, mm-hmm. right? You can't teach touch. You either have it or you don't. And that's a nice place to start, a kid with that size with some nice touch.
Yeah, that's hard to guard.
And some willingness to work, which she obviously has that too. Up for Ava Mitten, 2 points. And that's a popular hoop from the bench. You love to see it when the kids that don't get too much of an opportunity. And Allman again. Man, Mia Allman doing work inside. 12 points now for her since her appearance in the game. Looks like he's going to come back with the starters again. That's Coach Troy McKenzie for at least a couple more minutes. Allman in there ripping it away, but it's going to stay with Bernice McNaughton. I would imagine he's probably going to go a couple minutes here with this five and then come back with the bench five to finish the game, I'd imagine.
I think you may be right.
Maybe keep up the conditioning a little bit for his starters. But five, approaching halfway through the fourth quarter now. And Troy McKenzie, a very animated coach. He's got a couple of animated players. Reflect him. No more than Brooke Watson. And who I think, I don't know. Again, we don't get to pick the players of the game, but I do enjoy playing this game. And from Bernice McNaughton, it's been such a tough game for them. Really couldn't get anything going offensively.
I think Reese Mann, though, she's come out and she's knocked down a couple big threes, made a couple huge defensive stops, and she's kept her Highlanders going. So that'd be my pick.
Yeah, it's a good pick. They like to spread it around, and Reese has already gotten a player of the game. Ella McNally got one, too. But, yeah, it's been a tough game offensively for Bernice McNaughton, but good effort from them. We'll see what they come out of the huddle with. Probably continuing to play some of their younger kids. Get a little bit more action in this year's edition of the Hoop Classic. Come out tomorrow, try to get themselves a win in their final game. So Kickert in the corner. Going to face a double team there probably, and she does. Man, those are some effective double teams. Gets a foul though. Get some of those kids with such length. DeVarin.
Such a smart read by Lindsay Black to see that.
Yeah,
and
for sure.
Immediately gets fouled. Yeah. She's one of those players that whenever she comes into the game, whether it's offense or defense, she's making a difference.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, she's going to watch you. She's going to want to probably tomorrow be better served watching those touch fouls tomorrow in the first half against St. Malachy's. They're going to need her. They can't have her step out for a whole entire quarter.
Beautiful pass by Brooke Watson underneath.
Yeah, ho-hum. Another nice Brooke Watson pass.
To Isla DeVarens.
Dropping dimes. She's has to be leading this tournament in assists. And blocked there by Black. just the type of point guard you always want to play with is Brooke Watson. Very unselfish. Can tell she takes pleasure in setting up her teammates. She's going to go to a spin move here and comes up short.
Yeah, tries to force one up there.
She did. Troy McKenzie, they're exchanging a laugh about something. Don't make fun of your players, Troy. You've done worse moves than that. Kicker gets it picked off. A Black's going to lead out Watson, and she's going to come up with another lay-in with a left hand. And he's already looking at that five on the bench and saying, okay, here's when you're going to go in.
And then it's coming as they take and their masks off to
here
head
it goes.
Up.
Yep. Just got them quick minute. Right back in. Amadou with a rebound and an outlet. And quick as you like down the floor. Led a little bit too much as Watson saved it, but out of bounds. And that'll be the last that we see of the Moncton starters in this game. They've done good work. And they'll be sitting and resting and ready for the St. Malachy Saints tomorrow at 5 p.m. here from Crandall in front of some fans. Looking
yeah,
forward
there's
going to
be
it.
a lot of JV girls, a lot of happy JV girls here in the gym tomorrow to cheer on the for the gold medal game.
And I think it's a good idea. You and Kelly on the call for the girls' final.
We'll see if Kelly will agree with doing that with me, but
Kelly,
I would have fun.
Kelly, it's up to you.
She might be listening at home right now.
I'd be willing to break my streak of doing consecutive games in this tournament. I know you guys, I wanted to break you guys up, but you know, you both have other things going on in the morning tomorrow, and so I'm going to have to find some other partners for the girls' games in the morning. But fans, we don't have our regulars most of the day tomorrow that you've heard all week, so I'm going to be, it's going to be like one of those award shows. I'm going to be pulling up people. Hey, let's talk to this guy for 15 minutes.
Yeah, celebrity guest appearance.
Yeah, absolutely. We're going to get the best and the brightest in Moncton basketball sitting with me tomorrow. But I think we want the ladies' final to be called by yours truly over here to my left and Kelly Vass.
I'd be honored.
So, Kelly, it's up to you. If you're too chicken, though, I get it.
She's definitely at home.
She's definitely just
ripping on you.
She's just angry right now, chomping at the bit. Oh, Evan, she hasn't messaged yet. That's weird. I figured I'd hear from her by now. Apthorpe.
Bringing the ball up, looking to see her bigs inside.
Oh, just a little misread. Done it. Looks at the bench going, yeah, that's me. Alwyn was leaning one way and the pass went the other. Alwyn wants it on that left so she can go over the left shoulder. Not comfortable going over that left shoulder yet, but nope. Here come the messages from Vass.
She's listening. She's very angry.
You normally don't want to make Kelly Vass angry.
No,
but
definitely
I don't
not.
But I don't
least
have to play least against
she isn't
her.
On the court right now,
I
so
I don't
we should be able to handle
her.
It yet.
Do a better job than you, she says. I mean, listen, I can't argue that. I'm not that good. But listen, Kelly, it's up to you. See you here tomorrow. All ladies matchup, all ladies broadcasting.
Ooh, good
team.
Good pass by
oh,
Apthorpe.
Oh, that was
there,
sweet. To Apthorpe, and she loves it.
Pretty
I love
bounce
the,
pass.
I love the reaction of the kids when they do something extra. And that was a very, very extra special pass. Sweet feed to Alwyn. Oh, just a little bit short there is Mowat. It's going back to the Purple Knights. Apthorpe again. See what she can conjure up. 14 points now for Alwyn posting up in there since she's been in.
Was that a three in the key call?
Looks like it. That was pretty quick. Refs are usually going to put away their whistles at this point of the game. Something like that, but still making the call he feels is right.
That's all right. She'll just benefit from it and learn from experience for tomorrow's gold medal game.
Mowat with the Eurostep jump shot. All right, that was creative. That was kind of like LeBron throwing up off the glass to himself. That
oh
was
yeah.
Mowat throwing it up off the rim to herself. Recognized she was in trouble. But, man.
Moet getting compared to LeBron James up here.
Listen, not for the last time. Look at her. She's going to get. We're in 23? Oh, no, only three. Up for a free throw is Moet, Olivia Moet. More bounces. Let's see if she can convert 2 for 2. Nope, misses one, but a rebound there from Reese Mann. Turns and spins up over there with a right hand.
Pretty hook shot over her shoulder.
Yeah, that's not an easy shot from Mann.
Ooh, some pressure here from Moet.
Apthorpe turns it over.
And a blocked.
Yeah, Moet's going to get two more shots.
Should get a chance to go 2 for 2 here.
Creating some things is Moet. It's not looking good for the all-female broadcasting team, I don't think. I think
what's Kelly saying?
No, she gave me a shrug. She said, I do a better job than you, but with a shrug. So, you know, those silly shrug emojis. So I think she's going, I don't know. Come on, Kelly. You can do it. Done it. Pulls down the board. Over to Apthorpe. Hamilton inside to Alwyn. Nice feed. Good touch. 16 from Holman in there since she's been in. Impressive stuff. And another sub in.
For Olivia Moet. She had a really strong quarter.
She did have a strong quarter, yeah. Might have earned herself some player of the game consideration, although she's already been given. But Kamara Foster in for her. Swung over to Kamara Foster. Puts it on the deck.
Reese Mann from way outside.
Yeah, you're right. But rebounded by Foster, and Mann is going to try again. Yes, and well, she should. She was open, but missed to the left. Done it. Up to Apthorpe.
Pushes it. Gets to 2 feet. She's unable to finish.
Yep.
Oh, Hamilton comes up with it. Yep. Gets it over to Dunnett.
Dunnett with a little.
Pretty little floater finish.
Nice little Euro step action a little bit. Goes up off 2 feet and finishes. Well done by her. And Reese Mann. Into the corner. Shot fake. Oh, good look inside, but it just wasn't there. Closed off by Hamilton. Rebecca Mills up to Apthorpe. Over into Allman again. Good box out by Reese Mann on Allman. And a nice dance inside by Reese Mann to finish with the left on both ends of the floor. Reese Mann doing work. Finishing with the left. Moncton High, under a minute left now. Alwyn in the, she's gonna put another one up off the back rim and off to Mann. Looking in the corner, nope, she's gonna take it herself. Up for two more, nope, off the front rim. Mills.
Got to give it to Reese Mann and the Highlanders, though, for finishing strong.
Yep.
They're not giving up, and they're pushing the ball, and they want to get points on the board.
Yeah, the effort's there, as always. Just this Moncton High squad is a special team. This is one that's particularly strong. And, you know, it's just sometimes you run into a juggernaut, and you don't have the same level of experience, and McNaughton doesn't. 5 grade 10s on this Moncton team.
Yeah, and it's really nice, too, to see this Moncton High program get turned around in the last 5 or 6 years. Since Troy's taken over, these girls have been really strong coming out, and there's been several girls that go playing at the next level. So props to Troy and the program that he's built over at Moncton High School.
Yep. Brooklyn McKay made a nice run there and just popped out. She won't try to get her on the board. It would have been nice, but Apthorpe going to finish off the game, 2 seconds, 1 second, and Moncton High on to the Hoop Classic Final tomorrow at 5 p.m. against the St. Malachy's Saints. And I'm going to take a picture of this scoreboard. They've already reset it. Man, they're fast. All right, they're ruining my social media posts, but I'm gonna let them go because they're doing a good job over there. So we'll stick around for the Player of the Game presentations. Fans, see who it is for either side.
I thought Sammy Abadou had a pretty good game, too. She was all over the place.
Man, you can give it to Sammy whenever you want. She does the same stuff every game. She gets 3,000 steals and takes 8,000 hits. Like, you know, that girl never misses a box out. Mm-hmm. Like,
another big
absolutely.
Player is Mia Ellman coming off the bench.
Yeah.
Pretty moves in the post.
16 points down there.
Grade 10 player making a difference for her team.
Nothing to sneeze at.
And Olivia Mowat will get it for the second time this tournament.
Okay. Not a bad choice.
Lindsay Black.
All right.
I have to believe that's her second time this tournament as well.
I guess. I mean, if you want to go the boring route and give it to the really good player.
She gives them a quick thumbs up.
She gives them a quick thumbs up. And our day comes to an end, fans. It was a long one for me, but I loved every second of it. And I'm looking forward to tomorrow. It's going to be a blast. And I hope I see a lot of you in here, and I will. I'll see you with your team early, and maybe we'll be broadcasting together. Maybe we won't.
Yeah.
Who knows? We'll play it by ear.
It'll
but
be
we'll
fun.
Have
the gym will be packed tomorrow with all the fans in here.
Yeah, it's going to be fun in here tomorrow, fans. So I hope you join us if you're not in town, not able to secure a ticket. I hope you're able to join us here on the live streams. We're going to have a blast tomorrow. There's going to be lots of different people joining me. It'll be interesting to find out who that is. So join us tomorrow morning starting at 9 a.m. Check the YouTube channel for what time the games are and who's playing, and we'll see you tomorrow morning.